a super cute, super easy, very beginner friendly crochet beanie. If you want like a style like this, what I did was take my yarn winder and mix a bunch of colors, like cut, do knots, wind, and I did that over and over. And this is the color pattern I ended up with, and I really like how this one turned out. But for this video, I'm gonna be using the color anthracite, and I already winded it up, and this is how it looks. And I'm gonna be using a 5mm crochet hook. I'm gonna start off by making a slip knot and then chaining 44. Half double crochets all around and then only on the back loops. So to make a half double crochet, we're going to loop over, go inside on the first chain, pull, and there should be 3 loops, and then with this one 4, and pull again. That's how you make a half double crochet, and we're going to continue making half double crochets until we reach the end. We've reached the end of our row, now we're going to chain 1 and turn our work, and from now on we're going to work only on the back loops. So we're going on the first back loop, second back loop, and we're going to continue doing this until we finish. I'm using a 5mm, so for me 22 inches will be enough. But if you're using a smaller hook size or larger hook size, that amount may vary. Same for the different weights of yarn. So we're going to continue this, and I'm going to come back when I reach the end of the row to show you how to maintain a perfect edge. In order to keep a straight edge, we're always going to half double crochet on the back loop of the last stitch. Same for the first stitch. We're not going to skip any stitches. We're always going to do the first and last. And that is how you keep a straight edge on your work. And I'm going to come back when I have my 22 inches done, and I'm going to sew it together. I was gonna show the sewing process of this, but then I forgot, and then I was like, it's okay, I'll just make another hat. I did the same thing, but it's okay, because I have one that I'm making as an order, which I will not forget, and so it's a two-tone hat, and in order to keep track of the even sides, you can count the side that's sticking out. It's hard to see because it's black, but this part is the side I count on, not this flat one. So just count to 11 and then 11 again. So it should be 44 rows total. So this is the side I want to be in the front. I'm gonna start over here. You're gonna go over here at the edge of both stitches, and then, you know, thread, and then we're going to whip stitch. So we're going to take the back loop and the inner loop, back loop and inner loop, back loop and inner loop, and then it's going to make this little like swirly type of stitch, and we're going to do that throughout the whole thing. We've reached the end, and this is how the back side looks like, but then the part that's going to be showing on front looks like this. So we're going to cut this, put this aside. Only one strand here, and since if we flip it inside out, which is the way it's gonna be, this part is going to be folded. So what I like to do is put this part behind here and unravel this and split it into two, and then I make a knot, and this makes a very tiny little, very discreet knot that you won't be able to see. 2, 3, and then I just cut it very close, and you can't even see that. There's a little closing over there. Now we're gonna flip it back. I want this part to be in the front, so I'm going to flip it inside out. And I'm going to sew in the top. It doesn't really matter where. I've seen people do it in the first one. I don't really like it because it leads to gapping. So I do it in the second one. And you just keep going until you reach the end. So now we've reached the end, and we're going to tie this up. Just so it's easier. I like to tie it a couple times. Two-tone beanie. It's very easy, very simple, and I really like doing these. They look very nice, and they're very soft and very stretchy. So, hope you enjoyed.